हरि ओम नमस्ते
हरि ओम
सॉरी फॉर द डिले कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन
यस यस
नॉट श्योर व्हाट इज शेयर जस्ट लेट मी चेक वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिशम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु वस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ धातु ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तौ जीव आख्यात मुच्यते प्रकृति कृत्य बंधादि धातु ब्रह्मात्मने नमः सो यू लुक एट द अच संधि एंड यू आर लुकिंग एट द हल संधि विसर्ग संधि वी हैड अ लुक एट इन अच संधि वी लुक एट द एग्जांपल For example, Rameshwara, Rama and Ishwara becomes Rameshwara. And others we are looking at, the chart said that you have to divide. There is a Dirgha, there is a Yan. So, where is the chart? So, the chart says, if you look at it, what are the possibilities of Sandhi? Ach with Ach. When Ach is followed by Ach, then Ach is divided by Akara. Akara is one part. Ik is another, which means E. U, R and L. This is another second part. Third part is H, A, O, I and O. This is what follows. And similarly on the Purva side which precedes. So, A, A, Ik, Eng and A. And in fact, on the Purva side, there is also the division of H is into Eng and there is an Eng also. The division is Eng. A, O is Eng. And A, O, I and O, that is H. So, A, out of H also, Eng is taken out because there is another Sandhi there. And we have seen the term, specific Sanya, the terminology called Guna and Vriddhi. Guna are A, O and A and O. These are Guna letters. And Vriddhi are I, A, I and O. These are the three Vriddhi letters. And that these letters, particularly which letter is the replacement is shown in the chart. When A is followed by EE, you get A Sandhi, Rameshwaraha. Then O Sandhi when A and U come together, whether it is Dirgha, Raswa, both ways. This Sandhi is O. Then Ar we saw there is a Repha which follows when Guna letter is a replacement for An. So you get Ar for A, A and Ru you get Ar. And A, A and L, you get Al. This is the Sandhi. When A, A, A or A is followed by A, you get I, which is Vriddhi. So for I, I for Akara and Aikara, the closest should be taken and that is I. Similarly, when A, A is followed by O, you get O. Followed by I, you get I itself and followed by O, O itself is the Adesha. Sometimes the Adesha, the replacement is for the Purva, sometimes for the Para, sometimes for both. And there are various types of Adeshas as to whether it is a Guna Adesha, Vriddhi Adesha or Para Adesha itself, the last letter itself or the earlier letter itself is the Adesha. These are the possibilities. Then Yan is another Sandhi which is Yavara and La are the letters for Yan. Yan Pratyahara, if you expand it, you will get Yavara and La. This Yakara, Vakara, Repha or Lakara are the Adeshas when E is followed by A. When E is followed by A, then you get Yakara because E and A, the formation if you look at it, Sthani and Sthana, Sthana and Uchcharana Sthana and the proximity, the closest, which is the closest letter, if you start finding, then you will get the yakara. Another thing, another way to find out, I had mentioned is if you just say it fast, you see how the tongue rolls. It naturally it will roll to yakara. Ya, ya, you will get ya. Close to ya, and then you can conclude that is yakara. In most cases, you'll be right. Similarly, ua, you'll get va, ua. So u and a sandhi is va. R and a sandhi is repha. And there's no example for lu and a, there's no example. Similarly, this ik when it is followed by ee, based on that, if it is savarna, as in it is of the same varna, ikara and ikara, there will be dirgha sandhi. Ukara and ukara will be a dirgha sandhi. U you'll get, and ru, same letters, savarna letters, you'll get ru. Dirgha ru, you'll get. This is dirgha, but other places you'll get ya, va, ra, or la. So ya, va, ra, because there is no example for l, e, u, r, when it is followed by any other letter than savarna, then you will get yand sandhi. So e followed by any of a, a, e, u, r, r, a, o, I, or au, you will get yakara. But yakara plus a, e, u, which letter follows, that remains. So you will get, so e plus a will be ya. It will not be yakara plus akara, you will get ya. E plus e will be dirgha. So savarna dirgha you take out. Other than that, e and u, there is the sandhi will be e and u will be ya, but ya plus u will remain, so we will get u. So u and so on. The para vowel will remain, but it will form a sandhi and it will be an addition. So that's another sandhi. Similarly, U when followed by Ach will be Vakara plus that Ach letter. So you'll get Va, Va, Vi, Vu based on what follows. And similarly, R when it is followed by Ach letter, you'll get Repha and whichever letter is R, Ra, Ri, Ru, but except for Savarna letter, whichever is the following letter, if it is same as the previous letter, same as in Hraswa or Dirgha, if it is a Savarna of the same type, then you will get dirgha, you will not get yand. Now if a o i o, which is h, ing plus h is h, if that precedes and an ach follows, then what is the sandhi? The sandhi is what is called ayava sandhi. You will get I of I or av. Just like you got yand, you will get I of I or av. So for each of these four, whatever ach follows, you will get I of I or av. That is the replacement. Now, except for ing. When ing is there, then ing is what? A or O. So when A or O precedes and any ach follows, then you get this. There is an elision. There is an elision of the second letter, and you get. So it is given here in footnote 1. When A or O, meaning ing, at the end of a pada, specifically at the end of the pada, is followed by a short akara only. Only when it is followed by a short akara, then A or O remains. Purva Rupa Sandhi. Purva Rupa Sandhi. Purva is the Adesha. A is followed by Ach, where Ach is an akara. Then A is the Adesha for both. Both as in the akara is dropped. It will look as if akara is dropped, because Purva is the replacement for Purva as well as Para. The earlier is the replacement for earlier, and later. Later is only a, the letter a, not a, e, u, r, or the other ach. This rule does not apply to other ach. Similarly, o. If o precedes and akara follows, then o is the replacement for o as well as a. And this is marked when it is printed. Some of the books will show this, the S kind of a symbol, which is called avagraha. So avagraha is optional. Based on how many letters are dropped, if akara is dropped, you will get an avagraha single one. And in some other cases, in say for example in dirgha sandhi, akara is dropped, and that akara drop will be shown as double avagraha. But this is a printing. You cannot pronounce the avagraha. There is no pronunciation for avagraha. Avagraha is a printing symbol used by some publishers. It is optional. The person may or may not use it, but the pronunciation will be just like you, as if the avagraha is not there. No pause is there. Just read as it is, by dropping the akara as though. So this is the ach sandhi we were looking at. The example we had seen So jalaugha we have seen vriddhi brahma eva, tatha eva, tatha eva. So this is a vriddhi sandhi. Ma evam, maivam, that is the vriddhi sandhi. So that's how the replacement works. Yan sandhi we are looking at. In yan sandhi, iti ataha is ityataha. Iti plus ataha, you get ityataha yan sandhi. Now akara remains, but ya is an addition. Iti ataha, so you get that not an addition. Iti, the ya is a replacement for e. In the iti, that ikara, which is the ending ikara, it plus e, that iti, ikara is replaced by ya, yan sandhi, and ataha still remains. So you will get ityataha. Ityataha is the sandhi. Similarly, ityah. A remains, e goes, and e is replaced by ya. E goes means e is replaced by yakara. So you will get ityah. Iti evam, itti evam. Nadi evam, nadi evam. So a remains, nadi, e kara is replaced by yakara, nadi evam. That is yan sandhi yakara. Yan sandhi ya, va, ra, la. There are four letters. Vastu. Vastu asti, vastvasti. Vastvasti. Vakara is the replacement for u, ukara, and asti a remains. Therefore, you get vastva, vastva, and vastvasti. Guru adesha a. U is replaced by vakara, you will get guruva, guruva, and adesha, guruvadesha. That is vakara in yan. Then repha, repha in yan, when you get that, iti. So, okay, there's a split here, yan sandhi resolved. Yeah, so yakara, sorry. Earlier itself, yeah, ru. So dhatu, dhatru and ausha, dhatraunsha. Dhatraunsha, the ru, the vowel ru is replaced by repha. Akara means you'll get dhatraunsha. 15th example. 16th is pitru uktaha. Pitru ukta in a samasa, you will see this. Pitru ukta. So pitru is the pratipadika, ru anta. Ru anta, rukaranta. Rukaranta, pratipadika. And when it comes in association with a following ach, following vowel, then you will get repha as an adesha for rukara, but the vowel will remain. It is a, only the purva is replaced, that is the sthani, meaning that which takes a replacement. Only ru will get a replacement of repha, u will still remain, and you will get pitrukta, repha pitrukta, not pitru ukta, but pitrukta. That these are the yan letters. Lu example is not seen. So ya, va, ra, la, lakara example is not seen in this. How do you split the sandhi? Ityartha, yan sandhi. So you see ya is a replacement ik. So ik and yan. Ik and yan. If you resolve ik on left side and yan on right side, then that is the yan sandhi. And it is one-on-one adesha. E has a ya. Ya, e, e, u, ru, ru on left side. And on right side you have ya, va, ra, la. So it is a one-on-one adesha. Respectively. So iti artha will be ityartha because e has been replaced by ya. Similarly, if you look at ityuktam, u, iti uktam, that u is following para, but ityu, yakara is the replacement. You see yakara is the replacement for ikara in ik, since there is a one-on-one correspondence. So you say iti uktam, ityuktam. Pashwadi, if you look at this, Pashwadi, you see Adi sitting on the right side. So what remains is Pashva. On the left side, you get Pashva with a Halanta, Vakaranta. And Vakara is a replacement in a Yan Sandhi. You, Vakara is the second letter in Yan. Ya, Va, Ra, La. And on left side, Ik is there. In for Ik, Yan is the replacement. Ik, what is the Ik? E, U, Ri, Ru. So second letter is U. So you say Pashu Adi is Pashwadi. That is how you resolve the Sandhi. And so on. Kartradi. Kartradi is Kartru. Ru, the, ru is the vowel which is preceding. And Adi. A is the following letter. And the Sandhi is Yan Sandhi. Repha is the replacement. So when you split the Sandhi, you should get what is on the left side instead of the Repha on the right side. And the third letter in Ik is Ru. So you'll get Kartru, Pratipadikam and Adi. So it's a samasa, kartru adi eshamte. Kartru and adi will become kartradi. Like we saw the yan sandhi, other examples, similarly you resolve it in this similar manner. Ayavayava sandhi or called as ayadi sandhi. Ayadi sandhi, ay, av, I or ava are the adesha. We will not look at the sutra, but the examples, look at the examples. Hare and this a letters. हरयः, यू विल गेट हरयः बिकॉज हर हर ए विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय अय, इट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑन वन आदेशा. वॉट इज रिप्लेस इज एच, एच ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय अय, औ आय एंड आव ऑन द राइट साइड. सो इट्स अ वन ऑन वन करस्पॉन्डेंस. ए इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय अय एंड वॉट वी सॉ इन द चार्ट, ओ इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय औ एंड देन यू हैव आई रिप्लेसमेंट फॉर ए ओ आई, आई आई इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय आई एंड ओ इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय आव. दिस इज हाउ दी वन ऑन वन करस्पॉन्डेंस. जस्ट लाइक हियर यू हैव अयादि संधि, अयवाया अव आई एंड आव, अयवायवा अयवायावह, दैट इज दी संधि. गुरु सो ने ने इति, अनदर एग्जाम्पल, सो ने अति नयति, दिस इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द वर्ड. वी डोंट नो वॉट इज अति. So when you do subanta derivation, meaning the noun derivation, you will see this harayaha, and in tinganta derivation, in deriving the verb, you will see this sandhi within the formation of the word. But other places, you don't see much of this sandhi, like asau iti, since it's a difficult sandhi to see the form, the way the tongue rolls is a little tricky. Since we have lost in the language, we don't use it so often. Therefore, you don't, many people don't make this sandhi when they start writing some things. These days, we don't see so much of this sandhi, but in Grantha, you'll see this sandhi, and especially this sandhi being mandatory in a pada, in a quarter of a verse, there you will see a lot of this sandhi. In Gita, you will see this sandhi. In Eli Shloka, you will see, which has a chandas, you'll see this kind of a sandhi. And how do you identify it? You identify whether on the right side you have I, av, I or av, and based on that individually, respectively, replace with h, h which is a, o, I or av, respectively. One is to one correspondence in that order itself. So resolving or making the sandhi is easy. It takes only you have to understand the pratyahara. Otherwise, it is not that difficult. But pronunciation is a little difficult, and when you see the form, it is a little intimidating because you see a lot of letters put together, and we don't know where exactly is the sandhi is happening. So asaviti, if you see, then asaviti, you don't know the word asaviti. It's very difficult to see what is asaviti, but it is asau and iti. If you can make out this av in between, av or av sitting here, then you can assume that is an. If you don't know the words, this word, a single word or two words which have come together, you can't make out. Then you see the av, spot the av in between. Av, av, ay or I, and then break it as h. Respectively, you try to break it and you will land right, because you see av here, av being I, av, I and av is the fourth one. Therefore, in h, what is the fourth? A, o, I and av. So av has to be is the replaced one with av. So you split the sandhi by saying asau, av. You take asau, and asau is that. Asau means that. If you know asau in declension, it's a pronoun that. That iti, asau iti, or asau adityaha. In Sandhyavandana, we say asau aditya, that aditya, which aditya? Not that as in saha aditya. Saha will be far away, that aditya which is far away, which is not pratyaksha to me. But this aditya, this sun is pratyaksha to me. It is pratyaksha Bhagavan. We say aditya is Narayana, Surya Narayana, we say. So that aditya which is very close and pratyaksha to me, so asau. It is very close. And asau aditya, when you say asau aditya, you will have asau aditya, the av, ayavaya sandhi replacement will be av, you will get asau aditya. And there is another rule also. This asau aditya, sometimes you see as asa aditya, because the vakara is dropped, yakara or vakara at the end of this pada, which is followed by the sandhi, which is go apurvasya yo ashi. So an ash letter follows, that time it is replaced when preceded by this kind of a sandhi, ayavaya sandhi or yakara or vakara at the end of the pada. So sometimes there you'll see, instead of asaviti, you may see asaiti. So vakara is not visible, and that is the time when this it is difficult, because asa there is no word, and asaiti. The asa, you don't know the meaning, and there also when you see asa, dirgha form, so you can assume that something is dropped. So yakara or vakara, if you bring back, you'll be able to resolve the sandhi. I'm just mentioning is that in case there is a form like that. Like pavakaha is in the formation. So there we don't have a problem because the word is already formed. But in the sandhi like this, asaviti, we may have a little difficulty. If vakara is dropped, there will be more difficulty. Otherwise, if you remember ai, av, I and av, it is possible to resolve the sandhi easily by one-on-one correspondence with h. Bring back the h letter. For example, jayati, jayati. Jayati will be jayati. Kshayati will be kshayati. This is the formation of the word. We'll skip that because we are not doing the prakriya. So asavatma. So asavatma will be asavatma. Two well-formed words, when they come together, they form the sandhi. Asav atma, like asav aditya, asav aditya. Asav atma will be asav atma. Ubhavapi. Ubhavapi, both. So av letter you see. Av, when you say av letter, av is the fourth letter in H. A, I, O and av. Therefore, the replacement will be I, av, I and av. The fourth letter, fourth formation on the right side will be the replacement in ayadi, and that will be av. So av will be the replacement for av. So you will get ubhav api, ubhav api. Then pujar ho arisudana, pujar ho arisudana, one who killed Ari. Ari is the rakshasa who was killed by Krishna. So arisudana, pujar ho, that av will be replaced by av. You will get pujar hav arisudana, pujar hav arisudana. Then balav iha, again av, av sandhi with iha will be av. You will get balaviha, balaviha. Shayana, so anyway, I'll not shayi plus, I'll not treat this shayi plus ana, but since it is a verb, within the verb, within the word, the declined word, we'll see the sandhi between words, fully declined words. All of these examples till nine are examples of during the formation of the word. So we'll have to look at pratyayas, etc., which you have not seen, and it's not in the scope of this class. Tenth example, you look at vagartha viva. You can spot iva. Iva is in the ending, and vagartha iva, you know vag. Vag, you know vag. Artha, you can spot vagartha. So these are the words which are known in other Indian languages also. So vagartha can be one word. Iva, iva, if you know in Sanskrit, iva is like this. So vagartha and iva is there, but there is an av sitting in between. What is this av? So if you know ayavayava sandhi, that av can be replaced by the corresponding left side, whatever is the h, and that for av, the replacement, as in what is replaced, is the fourth. The av is the fourth adesha in the ayadi. Therefore, on the left side in h, you pick the fourth, which is av. So you get vagarthau, vagarthau, vagarthau. Which is in our prayer also, in initial prayer, we say vagartha viva sampruktau. That is this vagartha viva sampruktau. Like the vag and artha are connected. The word is connected with its meaning. Similarly, Parvati, just like Parvati and Parameshwar are connected, rather vagartha, vagarthau is an exemplified. The example given is just like Parvati and Parameshwara are always together, they are not separate from each other because he is an Ardhanarishwara, especially then. Similarly is the vagarthau. It is like the Ardhanarishwara, like Ardhanarishwara, vagartha cannot be separated. Vaga and artha, the word and its meaning is always together. And this is in the Purva Mimamsaka statement, and which is followed by Uttar Mimamsa, which is Vedanta. We also say that the word and meaning are never separate from each other. Word indicates the meaning. So when you say Rama, Rama means the word Rama itself is Rama. It is the entity Rama, which is Bhagavan Rama. There is no difference in meaning. Therefore, the japa is important. When you say Rama, 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 you are actually, while calling the Nama, Nama and Namni, the one who is denoted by the name, there is no difference. The artha, the meaning, as in the object, the meaning is the object. That object of that word is what it denotes. The vishaya of the vishaya, which is artha of the vak, the word, is the word itself. There is no difference between the two. So when you say Rama, it is as good as not only calling the name Rama, but it is Bhagavan Rama itself. The word itself is Bhagavan Rama. Then dvavimu. If av you see, av is the replacement for av. The dvav imav, imav, these two. Dvav imav means imav is these two. Imav itself is dual. So when you say these can be plural also in English. But these, how many are there? In imav, there are only two. So dvav imav, if you say imav itself, then you know it is dvav imav. Only two can be possible in imav. but it is specifically said in the shloka do vimu or in mantra do vimu, two of these, do and then imo, two words. Purushav ubhav, purusha purushah, purushav purushaha, ramaha ramo ramaha iti vat. Like that, purushav ubhav, ubhav is both of, and both can only be two. So which both? So two persons, not two devatas, not two rakshasas, two persons, not two animals, but purushav. So there the word purusha, how do you decline it? You have to decline it in the dual, just like ubhav is dual. Purushav ubhav will be purushav ubhav, because you see av here, av is the replacement for av. Most of the times you have seen av here as replaced by av. Others are in the formation of the words, most of the places you don't see. This is why the examples are not there. So the one elision that I was mentioning is what is called as lopa shakalya, that is an optional sandhi. Shakalya rishi has this opinion that it has to be replaced when you have a eto ayavayava, the h is replaced by ayavayavaha, which is the sandhi we just saw, the first four of h, the sorry not first four, the four of h are replaced by ay av I or av, then sometimes the vakara is dropped. Yakara or vakara at the end of that pada is dropped. For example, like tasmai aham will, I will be replaced by h. I is h, which is a I o av. So that is replaced by I av, and I being second in h, you will get the replacement as av, in which is second in ayadi. So tasmai aham will be tasma. A I O O. So A is third. I'm sorry, A is third. A O I O. So A Ong I O. So I is third, and the replacement is I, not O, I. So you get Tasmai Aham. Tasmai Aham, but you don't see the form Tasmai Aham. Sometimes you see most of the times you see Tasma Aham. That Tasma Aham is there. Yakara is dropped. That Yakara at the end of Tasmai is dropped, and you get Tasma Aham. This is the lopa shakala. The lopa happens of yakara or vakara. It is an optional sandhi. So you can see the form tasmai aham when sandhi is not done, tasmai aham when sandhi is done, and tasma aham when optional lopa of yakara is also done. You can see tasma aham, like asa aditya. Asa vakara is also dropped. Asa aditya. And so on. So we'll skip this sandhi. We've seen enough. Then Puro Rupa Sandhi, the one sandhi which is taken away from H, Ayavayava, H is replaced by Ayava, Ayava, I, Av, I and Av, Ayavayava, for that is, there is a Puro Rupa Sandhi. Only when Aang is followed by Akara, A or O is followed by Akara, then Puro Rupa is the Adesha, and Puro Rupa means A or O, whichever is the, if A follows, A is followed by Akara, then A is the Adesha. If O is followed by Akara, O is the Adesha. For both A and Akara or O and Akara, it is a single earlier letter which is the Adesha. Like for example, Kale Api, you will get Kale Pi. Akara is the Adesha for A as well as A put together. A is elided, and in print sometimes you get this Avagraha, S kind of a symbol, English S kind of symbol to represent it. But when chanting or when reading it, when stating it, you cannot have this Avagraha. What is, how do you read it? Kale Pi. Kale Pi is the reading, not Kale Api. There is no pause. Kale Pi. You can't pause there. There is a sandhi. So there has to be a fast pronunciation. You cannot pause between the sandhi letters. When the sandhi is formed, you cannot pause. So you say Kale Pi. Kale Pi. So aham. So aham, the sandhi will be, O will be the Adesha for Okara as well as Akara in so aham. You will get soham. Soham. The Avagraha cannot be pronounced. Soham. So you say soham soham dhyana dharo. So soham, that I am Brahma. So that is the Advaita soham. Lokesmin. So lokesmin is the Akara is elided, as though it is not really elided. For both there is the Purva Rupa Adesha, but it will look as if lokesmin Akara has gone. So technically, although wrong, but you can say that Akara is gone. Lokesmin, not lokesmin, lokesmin. Tedya aravate Arjuna etetra kalepi teham mokshase shubhat. So you see, mokshase shubhat, when you form the sandhi, it will not be mokshase ashubhat, it will be mokshase shubhat. Now दिस कैन बी इंटरप्रिटेड इन टू वेज. मोक्ष से यू यू विल बी फ्रीड फ्रॉम वॉट अशुभात, पंचमी अशुभात, फ्रॉम अशुभात, और इट कैन ऑल्सो बी स्प्लिट एज शुभात बिकॉज अ इज ड्रॉप्ड. And when Shubhat itself is the word, then also you will be saying Moksha Se Shubhat. And when Ashubhat Akara is as though elided, the effect in the Sandhi of Purva Rupa Sandhi, then also you will say Moksha Se Shubhat. So it can be Ashubhat. When you split the Sandhi, you can say Moksha Se Shubhat or Moksha Se Ashubhat. Based on the context, it is interpreted. Otherwise, you will get exactly opposite meanings. And therefore, we need Sampradaya to tell. Some Bhashyakara, some commentator, will not some Bhashyakara. Bhashyakara, there is only one, Shankaracharya. Bhashyakara or some commentator or sub-commentator tells us, or we learn from our Acharyas who teach as to how to break the Sandhi. It should be meaningful also. You can't just say Moksha Se Shubhat is possible. Nobody wants to be freed from auspiciousness. So it will be nonsensical to say that one will be freed from nobody thinks as auspiciousness as a bandha. Therefore, Moksha Se Ashubhat, not Moksha Se Shubhat. But in Vyakarana, both are possibilities. Here it may not be meaningful, other places it will be meaningful, and there commentators will give both possibilities. How do you interpret if it is without that a, and how do you interpret when it is with the a? Both possibilities are explained. Then Pararupa Sandhi, we'll skip this because this is only in the case of Apadanta. We are not doing Apadanta. Apadanta is only when the word formation is there. So we'll skip this. It may be important in this thing, in samasas, in compounds, but we'll see that when we see samasa, when we see particular words. Hal Sandhi. Hal Sandhi, Nalopa. One is Nalopa. This is not an important sandhi here, but I'll just mention it. Yogin Pratipadika, when you decline, you get Yogi Dirgha. So Dirgha is in some prakriya, some rule applies and you get Yogin. Yogin becomes Yogin in the first case, singular. And this Nakara, which is at the end of the Pada and end of the Pratipadika. So Pada as in derivation, when it is declined, you get Yogin, and Yogin will be the form, would have been, except for this rule which says this Nakara which is at the end of the Pratipadika and Nakara which remains after derivation applying rules at the end of the Pada, which is a declined word, then that Pratipadika Nakara and Pada Nakara, ending Nakara, if they are same, then you elide it. So you will get not Yogin, but you will get Yogi. So Yogi, Yoginau, Yoginaha. That is how the Inanta Yogin Shabda will decline. Yogi, Yoginau, Yoginaha. Yoginam, Yoginau, Yoginaha. This is how it will decline. Then there is something called as Kutvam. Kutvam means what? Ku is, we have seen, Ku is a short form. There are five vargas. Ka varga, pa varga, cha varga, ta varga, ta varga. We have seen, I mixed up the order, but this is how we say there are five vargas. And ka kha ga ga nya, cha cha ja ja nya. All five are indicated by a short form which is Ku. So, Kutva means Ku Varga. Kutva is Bhava Nirdesha. Bhava is status. So status of becoming Ka Varga will be called as Kutvam. So any letter, if it takes Kutvam, Kutvam means it takes status of Ka Varga, that is what is called as Kutvam. It will become one of the letters of the Ka Varga. When it is an Adesha, Kutva is the Adesha, is the ordained rule. Rule ordains Ku as the replacement. Ku is the replacement means what? The letter which is replaced takes Kutvam. That's how we'll see it. It will become Kutva. So Kutva means what? It will become, it will take which is the closest in proximity of Sthana and Prayatna, effort and this where the tongue touches, where the tongue touches and where the sound originates from the mouth, that is called as the Sthana. And the effort taken for whether it is internal or external affair of effort, that effort is what? We have seen the chart, earlier chart. There is a chart of which is the effort and sthana, and the closest to the closest ka varga letter in sthana and prayatna is the replacement, closest to what? Whichever is being replaced. So we have to compare and see which is the closest letter as a replacement in ka varga, and that will be the replacement when you say there is a kutva. So what does it actually means is that the cha varga, there is a one rule where it says cha varga, when jhal letter follows in the at the end of the pada, a jhal letter is following the end of the pada, and which is that at the end the cha varga letter is there. So cha varga takes a ka varga adesha. So what is the rule saying? That chu means cha varga letter is followed by a jhal letter, and this chu should be at the end of the pada. The chakara cha varga letter, cha cha jha jha nya, at the end of the pada, end of the word, declined word, when it is followed by a jhal letter, and jhal letter is a jhaban ghada dash jhaba ghada dash khapa chata dash chata tau kapai shasa sar hal. So jhaban is jha, jha is fourth of the class, cha cha jha jha, jha is the fourth of the class. So fourth of the class, third of the class, second of the class, first of the class, and the sibilants, when you see those, first of the class, and then and the rest of the till basically what skipping var la initially in the a yundri look a ung ayouch hayavarat. The hayavarat is hal in the last hal letter is there. So ha is covered in the last sutra, again last Maheswara sutra. So hakara is covered, ha yavara la. So yavara la, these four letters excluding those, and then nyamagananam starts. So nyamagananam is the fifth of the class. So yavara and fifth of the class letters, five letters, barring those when whichever consonant follows, then follows what? Follows a cha varga letter, then it will take a ka varga letter as adesha. We'll see in the example. So actually I am talking about padanta. At the padanta, sorry, not jhal letter. In the formation of the word, jhal letter should be following. But padanta is another possibility. So this rule is talking about two things. It should be at the end of the pada, or it should be followed by a jhal letter. So jhal letter we'll skip now because it is only the formation of the word. So assume that cha varga letter at the end of the pada is replaced by a ka varga letter. This is the sandhi rule here. So it will take what is called as kutva. So for example, much plus ta is jhal letter. We'll skip this because it is in the formation of the pada. But at the end of the pada, let's say end of the pada. Here also this will be applicable only in. So this rule is applicable only in a technical definition of pada, end of the pada, and that fully declined word we'll see later where how it will come. For example, let's say say ritvij. Ritvij is the word, or vach is the word, but it is the declined word. So ritvij is a possible declination of the word, but not bhyam. Forget this bhyam. But if you have a end of the letter ritvij only, you are pausing there, then that ritvij cha cha ja, there is a cha varga letter because it is third of the cha varga, cha the group class letters which are cha cha ja ja nya, their ja is the third letter, and chakara chakara cha cha chakara chakara jakara, third jakara being a third of the class here is replaced by the ku letter. Ku letter means the ka varga letter, ka kha gha. So gha is the replacement. So you say ritvij will become ritvik. Forget bhyam right now, but in declination if you are interested, bhyam is the is a supratya. So ritvij bhyam will become ritvik bhyam in third case dual, fourth case dual, and fifth case dual in the Sumanta declination when you decline the noun. But otherwise ritvij, if ritvij is the word, declined word, fully declined word, then ritvij will optionally will be ritvik also. This will not be technically correct, then there may be multiple rules applying and it may come back, but I am just showing you how the rule works. Kutvam, which is the closest to, in pronunciation, or in if the adesha letters are numbers are same as the stani letters, meaning what is replaced, the number of replacement, the rule ordains something where the number of replace and number of replacements, as in left hand side and right hand side number of elements are same, then it is a 1:1 replacement. So kutva is one possibility. Then we have shatvam. Shatvam is another possibility, which says there are some verbs and then some dhatus, basically some dhatus which are followed by a jhal letter. Will take shatvam means murdhanya shakara. The shanmukh shakara is the adesha for the shakara, the shankar shakara. So I'll skip through this because this is a little for specific to dhatus. And in, it is not applicable in padas, you don't see it. It is mostly in formation of the word. Now, this is important. Jhalam jash ante jash. Okay. So, what here the adisha is padanta jhal letter takes jash. Jash means we have said jash. Jashtum. So, we will call it a jashtum. Padanta jhal. Jhal means a jhal letter starting from the fourth of the class to the first of the class, all these letters. And the what follows. So, you will get. जबगड़ादश खप चटत चटतव सो खप चटत चटतव ख खप चटत चटतव फर्स्ट ऑफ द क्लास कपई विल एंड विद द फर्स्ट ऑफ द शस स श श स एंड सो ऑल द स स दंते सकारा दंते सकारा मूर्धन्य मूर्धन्य सकारा द षण्मुख सकारा एज वेल एज शंकर सकारा दोस थ्री आर ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड ह हल हकारा ऑल दीज फोर plus the fourth of the class, third of the class, second of the class, first of the class. When it is at the end of the, any of these letters is at the end of the pada, then it will take jash. Jash is what? Jabagada dash. Jabagada dash is cha cha ja. It starts from the third. So it's the third of the class. So all the fourth of the class, third of the class, second of the class, first of the class at the end of the pada and shashasar hal the shakara sakara shakara or hakara at the end of the pada are replaced by the third of the class and you have to see the closest in proximity. For example, marut. Marut when you decline, marut will be the in first case. So marut will become take. Marut is takara is the tatha. So it is the first of the class. So first of the class means it is a jhal letter. And jhal letter at the end of the pada. Marut is a fully declined pada in first case. So it will become marud dakara. Dakara is the replacement which is a jash letter ja ba ga da dash. So the dakara is closer in proximity to takara, therefore dakara is the adesha. And later there is another rule which can optionally bring it back to takara. Va avasane, there is a rule that it will take char adesha or jash adesha and it will come. So jash adesha is in the beginning which is mandatory, so you will get marud, and optionally there will be replacement by takara again. So the both marud and marut are both are valid forms in the first case, marut or marud, based on these rules. So this is how you'll see the variations. We'll see the rest of the rules in the next class and then move on to the panchavritti. We'll stop here. Om Tat Sat. Any questions?
हरि ओम. नौ दट टेबल वॉज देयर नो पूर्व पर इन दट वन पूर्व वॉट इज देर इन द पूर्व इट शुड बी ऐच नो वृद्धि आदच ऐच शुड बी देर नो यंग आई थिंक इफ यू ब्रिंग दट
नो दट इज नॉट अ वृद्धि संधि वॉट दट इज नॉट द वृद्धि संधि. That वृद्धि आदच इज द बिगिनिंग एंड वेन आई मेंशन एंग दट एंग ऑफ पदांत
चार्ट
इज द क्वेश्चन हियर
दि क्वेश्चन इज लेफ्ट साइड इक इज देर एंग इज देर आई आउच दट द होल थिंग इज आईच बट आई आउच इज the replacement for that is a vruddhi. Any connection is there?
That is the vruddhi. Vruddhi letters are I, O,
vruddhi akshara. Yeah.
Ouch. Yeah. These are the vruddhi letters.
I, au.
No, not I. See, I, au are the vruddhi letters. I, au and I, au. See, it's a repetition here. Vruddhi, you see, A, O, I, au are replaced by I, au and I, au.
Okay.
So the, actually, vriddhi letters are three: A, I, and O.
Yeah.
So okay. What? A right, and yeah. O are replaced. A is replaced. A and I are replaced by I. O and O are replaced by O.
Yeah.
But there is no replacement of okay. A because A is not closer in pronunciation to any of the vriddhi letters. H letters, it is not closer.
Yes. That is one thing. And secondly, this moksha say this purva rupa sandhi splitting moksha say ashubha ata.
Yeah.
When you are, you know, you are going to write it as a one word, isn't it? Moksha se shubhata.
Yes.
Then when you want to break it, how can you break it as moksha se shubhat? When there is avagraha is there, that means you have to split it as ashubhat, isn't it?
No, why, avagraha, see, avagraha is printed. Avagraha is there does not necessarily mean that it has to be printed, it has to be broken as ashubhat only. Avagraha is a printing, but printing has no meaning. Printing avagraha has no meaning. I can still split it as avagraha is red. Avagraha is, as in, it is printed, but it need not be, it cannot be pronounced. So, the sandhi is avagraha. See, when the bhashya is written, that time there is no writing this avagraha. Avagraha business is much later in printing world. When somebody wrote the work earlier, that time there is no avagraha. So, the bhashya commentator can split it both ways because it is pronounced. Now, the printing when it is done, that time the person who is printed has put an avagraha. He may not be, the person who prints it, he may not be qualified enough to say whether the akara has undergone lopa or not, as in whether it is a puro rupa sandhi or not. He is not qualified. He is just a printer, publisher he is. But the one who facilitated that printing can be a vidwan. That is all right. So what you are saying is that somebody is helping you understand. But I am saying grammatically both are possible because it is pronounced. Avagraha cannot be pronounced. It is moksha se shubhat. It is avagraha. What if avagraha is not printed? That time also you will read the same way. When avagraha is printed also you will read the same way. So when I am teaching or when you listen to the word moksha se shubhat, when the words, it is not a single word. It are two words there. How do you split it? Somebody who has listened to it does not know how to split it. It can be both moksha se shubhat, moksha se ashubhat. So it has to be analyzed whether other possibility also exists. Because sandhi says that whether sandhi has happened or not, we do not know. Whether it is moksha se shubhat or moksha se ashubhat, especially when it is a part of a quarter in a verse, that time we do not know whether the sandhi has happened. Enga padanta dati, whether that sandhi has happened or not, we do not know. So you are saying in the printing world, but printing world we can't take for granted. Printing there can be errors also. Avagraha one may put for to help also, and it may be erroneous also. We do not know, so we should think of a possibility that other possibility also exists. And this is how you get more sampradaya. You get more of
that is
possibility. So you at least you should be aware of the possibility. That's all I'm saying.
Okay. So that means if I see a word like moksha se shubhat, how do I know if this avagraha, I mean pura rupa sandhi is there, ashubhat or what? Because I know the meaning both moksha se shubhat, that I can make out where there is avagraha or pura rupa is there.
Yeah.
In a different context, how do I know? Because
you won't know. You won't. For example, let's say in a dirgha sandhi. In a dirgha sandhi, the nanj may be there, may not be there. How do you know? There may be akara or akara, both are. So, if I say, so say ashuddha. So, if I have to say something and say, let's say, hey Rama, how do you say? No, not ashuddha will not work. Shuddha. So, in some, I am not able to think of the example, but if you can split as so dirgha sandhi is what? Akara plus akara is dirgha, akara plus akara is dirgha, akara plus akara is dirgha, akara plus akara is also dirgha. Four possibilities exist.
Yes.
How do you know which one?
And dirgha, both. Yes.
Yeah, and hasraswa dirgha on both sides. So in which case, not only akara, ikara also. So I am taking one example. There also, if you, when you split, you know akara is not a possibility on right side. Then you say akara may be a possibility. On the left side also you think that akara ending word it may not be. Akara ending sambodhana it can be. Therefore it can be this possibility. Or in even in samasa also. Rameshwara. Now Rama plus Ishwara is possible. Rama plus Ishwara is possible. Rama plus Ishwara is possible. And Rama plus Ishwara is possible. Or all these combinations are possible. Now you see that these are not valid words. Rama may not be a valid declension. So you say, or it can be. Rama can be Sita also. As in, it can mean.
Rama can be
a Strilinga. It can be. So, Rama, Ishwara is also possible. Yeah. Ishwara is not possible. Ishwara is possible. So, you say right side is resolved. It can be only Dirgha. But left side can be Rama or can be Rama also. So, how do you know? So, we don't know. It is, possibilities are there. In the context, it has to be understood. If we do not understand, you analyze as that both as possibilities. As far as we know, we say all these four are possibilities and all four are valid. We say all four are definitely valid. we do not know in what context the author meant it, and we say that all four are possible. Oh, that is why we need to get trained.
Yes.
As in, somebody has to teach us that in this context, this is the only possible meaning, or these are the possible meanings, or all are possible meanings. This brings some beauty to the kavya also in some places. And there is difficulty, yes, also. But these kind of difficulties exist in all languages. More or less, they exist in all languages. But in Sanskrit, there are rules which make it, at least you can analyze the possibilities.
Yeah, and then one more question, please. Nayati, you said ne plus ati, it is written there, I think.
I didn't
see properly.
Ne plus ati, actually. It is ni prapane plus ati, and then ni will become
prapane.
Ni prapane.
Okay.
Ni will become ne. So that's why I skipped it. It is in the formation of Tinganta Pada.
Yes.
Ati is that shap. So it is ni plus shap plus tip. So that's how you get ni ati, and that's how the formation
is.
Nayati.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Any other questions? Okay. So hopefully we'll be able to finish the sandhi in the next class and move on to the panchavritti. I think we are done around 10 classes or so. In another couple of classes, I've always been saying, so couple is, couple may mean two, can mean three, four. So we are going a little slow. Hopefully this is useful. I do not know how much useful it is, but hopefully for those who did not have any Sanskrit background, hopefully it will be a little helpful. When we go to Tattva Bodha, you'll see you'll be able to recall what we have seen in bits and pieces, and at least that must be helpful in Tattva Bodha. Those who do not want to spend a lot of time learning Sanskrit, this should aid in understanding Tattva Bodha and moving forward. So in a few classes, again, I've been saying few classes, hopefully in two, maximum three classes, we should land in Tattva Bodha. Okay, namaste. Thank you.